Welcome back, dear viewers. As we said earlier, that we are going to talk about youths today. As the National Youth Conference is taking place today in the resort of Sharm el Sheikh. And on this occasion, we are going to talk about means of developing skills of responsible leadership in fresh graduates and in youth in general. And to shed more light on this issue, I joined here in the studio with Dr. Mona El Arishi. She's expert in responsible leadership and corporate responsibility. Good morning, Dr. Mona.
Good morning, Shireen.
Good morning, Dr. Mona. Dr. Mona, to start with a definition, or what exactly is the responsible leadership?
Responsible leadership means that the leader, or even a young person starting his life, because we are all leaders in whatever we are doing and whatever we are doing, is able to understand himself very well. They are able to work in teams.
Yes.
And they accept the other's opinion, and they are very flexible to change.
The leaders are flexible to change because it's in a mindset for certain people that a leader is somehow stubborn, he does not change.
Yes, but what the responsible leader not only accepts change, but actually they drive change. Mm. And the last point about the responsible leadership is being able to act on their own values. Mm. So whatever the values of the person and the organization they are in, the leader is really like a role model in every action they are taking. Of course, this is reflected on youth. Those skills should be taught in the universities, in the last years of university. Actually, one of the major responsible leadership activities happen in the last year of the university in the States. Because they are now setting up the stage for the people, the young people joining the community and being active in their effective community change and updates and really doing a good stuff to the community. They prepare those young people by giving them this. They take a survey at the beginning of the year, and then along the year of the study, they start to scale up their skills, and at the end they do another survey to measure what has happened during the year. So this is now becoming very important because this is setting the stage for young people to start joining jobs, startups, even doing some community actions, because sometimes we do not find jobs, so we do volunteer. Mm. And from now on, I would love to really spread this idea about responsible leadership. And it's not just about a person being a manager, but just the person being able to manage himself and the community around them.
So what do you mean by manage himself and the community around him?
Okay. First step is understanding the self. Hmm. So the person, the young person coming out in life should know exactly what he or she are able to do and what their direction in life is. So they understand themselves. This is a bit of a psychology.
Yes.
And by the way, another aspect that I really preach everywhere I go is for people to understand more psychology. Hmm. Because psychology is about knowing yourself, about relationship with any person. Be that in life, like our personal relationship, spouse, children, parents, neighbors, and of course in the office. So this is a major study that we should be able to take. And this is the basis of foundation for knowing yourself. So once we understand what we do, because everybody has their own strengths and weaknesses. And the idea now for us, a responsible leader, is to understand both their strengths and their weaknesses. So once they understand their strengths, they build on it. Mm. And contrary to anybody who would think, they should not be working on their weaknesses. Mm. They should know it and get support from another to help fill this weakness or gap. So this is why working in teams, which is the second part of the responsibility, is very important, because nobody can do everything. Yes. So I know what I can do well, but I know that there are areas that I need someone to help me with and support me with. So those comes from a team member, either a peer or a manager or an employee, someone who is not my level but even lower level. Mm. So now we are starting to form the basis of a good office relationship because now I understand me and I know how to understand the other and I know how to fit to. I'm starting to act in a way that makes all the team members also accepting each other. Because the third part is being able to manage diversity, change, new ideas, creativity. So accepting and managing that and taking this asset to become a positive ideas and really driving forward the office is the third leadership, responsible leadership part. Mm. So you see how the jigsaw or the puzzle starts to build up?
Yes, indeed.
Knowing the self, knowing the other, accepting the self, and now we are able to create change, positive change, and by change I mean development. Mm. So we are now going forward in our progress in the organization. So we have a goal and we are going through this goal all together. And it's I always you know, make this description of this. This is like all the wheels in one of the motors. If any of the wheels are driving in the other direction, then there will be a negative
of course.
Going forward. Mm. So everybody should be working in the same direction forward. Mm. So when we are all aligned, now we are able to positively go forward. Mm. So change is accepted, creative ideas are accepted, good conflict and good discussions, no matter what are the others' ideas are and coming from. So we, from the manager point of view, a responsible manager, and I'm now talking about someone who has a position, is able to listen very actively to their employees and then write down or get to understand what we can do with those ideas. Mm-hmm.
Should we open up in order to accept these new ideas, maybe, which we were not used to accept before? Because I believe in the previous years, the managers or any boss has some stereotyping, has some ideas in his mind, which not to open up to a great extent to his employees, just to give order. And how can...
Okay. So this is a skill. It's basically... education and training, and then doing some, you become experienced in, it's like any learning cycle.
Yes.
First of all, you know that you don't know, so people seek to know, and then you know that you know, so they are learning this, and then it becomes a habit. They don't think about it. So this is why I'm saying that for young people coming out of the university or just starting their lives, be that in an office or starting their own organizations, because we see so many entrepreneurs coming out now in the market, it's very key to start up with this education and training, and then it becomes a habit. So it is becoming a positive, like a radiation, a positive radiation all over the society. Mm-hmm. And this is now the trends. International and global trends are going to educate even the young people and even the older ones, but of course the younger are easy to get to know a change and accept it because they're still flexible in their ideas. So now the international trends is about ethical leadership, responsible leadership, and we can take that a one level up, which is a spiritual leader. A spiritual leader is able to understand and feel also how the others' development on all aspects is coming. So if we don't want to miss that, we want to start where others end. Mm-hmm. So now international trends is about responsibility, ethics, and which is basically in our religions in Egypt. So our setup as in religions, either it be Christianity or Muslim religion, is all about ethics.
Indeed.
If we just take those ethics and put them in the office and how we do business as well, things will definitely change.
Hopefully, we can do that. Yes. Because sometimes we just talk about these things, but we do not actually practice.
Yes, definitely. Learning, education, and then taking that as a habit. And the message now for the young people in the conference in Sharm el-Sheikh is, guys, let's be an agent of positive change. And by doing that, you have to understand what you need to learn and then go for it. Because we don't really learn that yet in our universities, except in very, very limited areas in university. So let's take that as a call for the young people to start thinking about this as one of their skills that will make them successful in their lives, because it is a measure of success.
Hmm. So can we develop these skills, you mean responsible leadership skills in Egyptian women, to empower them?
Okay. In a survey about responsible leadership, and this survey was done among the Egyptian society, so yes. It was in companies in Egypt, the percentage, mm. oh, and it was about employees giving feedback on their managers mm. or leaders.
Yes.
And one of the questions was, is your manager a male or a female? So some statistics has shown that women leaders or managers are more responsible with the scale of responsibility mm. than men. I don't know the reason of that. We can first start analyzing and understanding which areas they come in more responsible. But I believe because the woman is always building up. So the woman is responsible for creating life in, yes. in at home, for example. Yes. And even when they are not yet married, and even the young daughter at home, she's always trying to spread a nice environment around her and among her peers and colleagues yes. and neighbors. So if we take this idea and start developing it, it could be a good positive also asset for women leaders to come forward and present themselves. If leadership and responsible leadership will be a measure for success, then young women and mm. women have a good opportunity to start, because by nature, they are more responsible in attitude. This is what yes. We have seen in those mm. in this survey specific, and this survey I have done myself.
Yes.
It's very, very important also. And maybe the young men will also feel a bit jealous and start working on themselves there. Mm.
Dr. Mona, how can we have here a clear message to the youth who are participating in the Sharm Sheikh conference and the others who are just maybe watching or they are not participating, that they should have these responsible leadership capabilities?
I have worked in the Egyptian society directly after the revolution till 2015 in the area of social responsibility, mm. corporate social responsibility. And during those 5 years, I was lucky to get to meet many mm. Young people in universities,
yes.
Just graduates, fresh grads, and also startups, mm. because we were supporting startups and trying to scale up the IT part of it. So
the IT startups.
Yes, especially mm. IT. This was my specialization. Mm-hmm. However, always we were looking at how can they also have social skills, responsible skills, and now we know about soft skills. So everybody mm. now can understand what excuse me, yeah. soft skills are, like communication skills, presentation skills, and leadership skills. But the area of responsible skills, and by the way, I have seen a lot of young people volunteering. Mm. This type of activity scales up the idea of responsible leadership, because now they feel responsible for their community and whichever, wherever direction they are after. So be that supporting the development of underdeveloped area, mm. going for more education, more health care. We have, I have met a lot of young people on all aspects that require support in the university. This is the main idea about responsible leadership. So this is already there. So what I'm trying to say is, it is already there. We have many young people already volunteering. Just let them turn that into actions in the office. Because when we volunteer, we are outside the community, you know, like we are working in a social aspect. Once we take that and implement it in the office, it just becomes responsible leadership. So volunteers who already done that are easy to go out and become responsible leadership. People who did not volunteer, and by the way, this is now very important on the CV, in Egypt and outside Egypt. People who never have done anything for their community, they are not looked at well in the interview, similar to those who have done. Because this means you have ownership. You are able to deliver on things that you believe in. So it shows that this guy, when they come, person, young girl or young man, when they come in the organization, they will be also loyal to their community, which is the office, the company. So we measure their loyalty by what have they done in their lives. Did they just study?
Serve their community, you mean?
Of course, as volunteers.
As volunteers.
So serving the community as volunteering and doing acts of responsibility is one of the measures now that will give a higher grade to any candidate. So
when applying for a job?
When applying for a job, absolutely.
Mm. What kind of community work you mean?
Anything. Anything. So you, whatever you do, you support even, you know, we have so many aspects.
Yes, indeed.
That we can support and serve in.
Yes.
It doesn't matter. As long as this person shows this trait in their personality, this shows that this person is reliable and we can continue to have their loyalty in a good organization. Mm.
Dr. Mona, since we are talking about the corporate responsibility here, does it become here more common for the multinationals to play an important role in showing responsibility towards the society? Because it was not very common in a few years ago.
There is a measure in the stock market about responsibility for the corporate. Mm. And it's not just for multinationals. It's for Egyptian companies as well. Mm. So this responsibility, it's a KPI that when you have it, you are in the first 30 companies in the stock market. Mm. You are not eligible to be in the first top 30 companies in the stock market unless you have responsibility shown clearly and manifested by the, and it's measurable as well, of course. Everything now is measurable. So it's responsibility to the community, to the environment, to your employees internally. And so it's actually measurable with the scale.
Indeed.
So, and we have this responsibility, report on monthly basis. And of course, how we manage our finances. So we're talking about corruption, anti-corruptive actions that are taken inside. All those aspects measure the responsibility of the company. And multinationals are very active in Egypt, but just want also to have the local companies join. And it's happening as we speak.
So nowadays, more national companies are starting to pay more attention to the social responsibility.
Absolutely. You find many, many foundations of local companies without mentioning names. I can just think now at least of five or six major companies.
Quite interesting.
Yes. Mm. In the area of health, in the area of education, in the area of women development, in the area of underdeveloped areas. So, I mean, now it's seen. Maybe we need to focus more from your side,
indeed,
from the media. We need to show those very bright
Many
examples.
Multinational companies do show that and the media.
Because it's
show
part
that.
Of the role model building.
Yeah, indeed.
When you are a good company and you show it, it's not just only for PR and for people to know that you are a good company. It's also as a role model.
Okay, Dr. Mona El Arishi, expert in responsible leadership and corporate responsibility. Thank you for being with us today.
Thank you
very much, Dr. Mona, and have a lovely morning.
Same to you.
And with that, our dear viewers, we come to the end of our first segment of the show. Now we'll go to a short break, and after that, we'll be back to resume our program. So stay tuned.